to a great start. Now, if you're anything like me, you're probably getting really sick of re-wearing the same sweatshirts and sweats over and over the past couple weeks. So I needed a little bit of variation. Over the weekend, I helped my boyfriend clean out his closet and I snagged his unwanted oversized sweatshirts and sweaters. And I'm gonna show you how I transformed them into cute, trendy loungewear. So if you're looking for a new project or you're tired of re-wearing the same sweatshirts, then see what you have laying around the house, grab a pair of scissors and your sewing machine, and let's just hop into this video. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and hit the subscribe button, and let's get to it. Okay, so I'm gonna go through the pieces that we are going to be flipping. First one is this kind of preppy, what is it called? I can't remember what it's called, but you know. This little preppy thing, and I'm going to show you how I cropped it and turned it into this. The second piece we have is this quarter zip sweatshirt. Now, I actually love this sweatshirt lounging around in. I like that it's oversized. I already wear this one to begin with, but I figured it would be the perfect sweatshirt to crop and cinch at the waist to make this one. Okay, so we're gonna start off with this knitted preppy sweater. I don't know what it's called. Anyways, we're gonna try to figure out where we want it to be cropped, the length. And we are gonna be keeping the waistband, so keep that in mind. This is just marking where we are going to attach the waistband. I'm attaching it with a pin, but you can also use a safety pin. So just measure it out and mark it in place. So this is a sweater laid out, and what I have done is folded up the waistband to the line that I marked. And you wanna make sure that it is evenly folded up front and back. And what we're going to do is make a straight stitch right under that waistband all the way around. We're not gonna cut the fabric because if it's chunky knit, you don't want the thread to unravel. So we're just going to stitch it right across that line, and that will be our cropped mark. So now we're going to start sewing, and I free eyed this, which is a bad habit, but I would recommend placing at least 4 pins, and that being on each side seam, matching up the side seam of the waistband to the sweater, and then center front and center back. There is a lot of stretch that you have to do, so if you place pins, it makes it easier to allocate and ease the stretch while you're sewing. Okay, so this is a sweater flipped inside out, and you're going to want to trim all the excess along your zigzag stitch. Mine isn't that pretty, I know, but if you wanted it to be really nice and neat, you can do so. It doesn't affect the sweater. I also did take the sides in 1/2 inch, which is optional. This sweater was a little bit tougher to work with, so it was necessary. But yeah, go ahead and trim that excess off, get your waistband fitting nice, and you're done. And this is a sweater turned right side out. I'm absolutely obsessed with it. The waistband went in really nicely. It may look gathered, but that's only because the waistband is smaller than the bodice, but it's sewn really straight and it fits nice. You do not like the way we play. Okay, so now we're on to the second sweater, and the first thing you want to do is figure out where you want your sweater to be cropped and mark that line. But keep in mind that we will be folding this up 1 inch to make a tunnel for the elastic, so it's really going to hit at that second line an inch above. So visualize it, mark it out, and then go ahead and grab your scissors, and we're just going to cut right across. If you have chalk at home, it also makes it really helpful to see. Do not cut the first line, cut the lowest line. So now we are going to pin up our hem, and I am using elastic that is a half inch in width. So I am folding up my hem 1 inch, and you want to make sure that you are leaving enough room in your hem so that your elastic fits comfortably. And once you do that, measure out your elastic. So you want your elastic to be the length of how tight or how loose you want the finished product to be. So I measure it by just wrapping it around my own waist. I kind of make it a little bit tighter because I do want this to be really cinched. Once you find that perfect fit, mark your elastic and then cut. Okay, so now back to sewing. I am just sewing up my hem with a straight stitch. There's no need for a zigzag stitch because I'm using elastic and this fabric on its own doesn't have any stretch. So go ahead and just sew up your hem using that straight stitch and make sure you are leaving at least the width of your elastic between your seam and the bottom of the hem. Okay, so once you're finished with that, we're gonna want to put our elastic in. So use a safety pin to anchor down the end of one elastic, and then we're gonna put a safety pin on the other end, and that's the one that we're going to use to feed it through the hole. The bigger the safety pin, the easier it is to feed it through, but just little by little, you're gonna inch it all the way around till you get to the end of the sweater. Now that I'm getting to the end, I'm going to want to grab both of my safety pins because we are going to stitch down the elastics and combine them together to make one large circle of elastic. And this is our finished product. It's super easy to do. All you really need is that elastic. I've taken a size extra large pullover from my boyfriend's closet and made it into a cute cropped sweater in my size.
Away, I do not like.